In 2019, when Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris got consumed by fire coming down with major destruction, everyone watching on the television, we all felt so bad. From everywhere, people pledged. They raised hundreds of millions of dollars to restore it within a day or two. It was a major news, breaking news all around the world. A week later, I read a beautiful article by the Jesuit priest, a famous author, James Martin. He discussed at length about the structure of the building, the construction of the building, and the true meaning behind it. He said, yes, it has got history. It has got its own architecture. It has got beautiful stained glass windows, statues, marbles, everything. But it is not everything. What is more important is our faith. The structure of the basilica or any temple or church should help us to worship. It should connect us with our Lord. Any human construction is vulnerable. The first reading speaks about how Maccabees celebrated the restoration of the temple after it had been defiled by Gentiles. Of course, it was renovated with the golden facade, shield and everything. Then, by the time of Jesus, over a century later, Herod the Great restored again the Jerusalem temple for his own vain glory. This one also short-lived. 40 years after Jesus' death, again it came down. The Jerusalem temple was destroyed. Yesterday in the gospel, we heard how Jesus wept over Jerusalem. Today, we hear how Jesus was seeking to restore the temple as a house of prayer. What we learn, what Jesus is trying to tell us. Temple or the place of worship, the structure itself, has no long-term future. But Jesus lives in the present moment. Our grand human construction projects are indeed glorious, yet they will eventually fall through war, neglect, or accident. The temple is vulnerable, but our faith should be strong. Every one of us is really proud about one church, as we do here as well. But our faith is not reliant on human construction. It holds good only when it inspires us to grow in faith. Only it helps us to pray in silence and also help others to pray well. Only when it deepens our faith and strengthens our relationship with God.